If you're camping in the bush somewhere in northeast South Africa, western Mozambique, or southeastern Zimbabwe, and you're camping under a tree with really, really rough bark, and you pick up some firewood and start burning it, and it gives off a beautiful smell, and then in a few minutes you start feeling slightly queasy, you know you're underneath a Tamboti tree, Spirostachys africana. How's it guys? I'm Gus, the African plant hunter. I am here at Nyavasikana camp on the Mwenezi River in Gonarezhou National Park and showing you a tree that is not widely distributed in Zimbabwe and really beautiful in its spectacular autumnal colors. So the Tamboti tree, which was well known to early settlers for its timber, which gives a characteristic smell like sandalwood, also discovered very early on that there are a lot of poisonous properties associated with it. So if you pick a leaf and break it open, you'll find a little white sap. Now that sap has a lot of medicinal uses. It's sometimes used as a fish poison. It's also used to put on your tooth to numb toothache. But if you drink a lot of it, you're going to get very sick and potentially even die. Now one of the easy ways to identify this tree, of course the sap is one, the very rough bark. Once you get used to it, as soon as you see that bark, you know that's a Tamboti tree. This bark, actually yesterday we came across a waterhole where there was a couple of big beautiful Tamboti trees just by the waterhole, and the elephants were coming along and using that bark to scratch against and really get themselves scratch that itch. And actually they'd rub the whole tree clean. It was quite a sight. Pan and giving themselves a good scratch against the bark. And right here it's absolutely smooth. If you look very closely, if you're still not sure, of course in the sort of autumnal colors you find a lot of these red, beautiful reddy yellowy leaves. And again from a distance it's really easy to identify the tree at this time of year. And another way, if you are wanting to look through a lens, if you were to look very closely at the base of each leaf, you'd find two little black dots, which are also completely characteristic. So you know, as soon as you see that, 100% this is a Tamboti tree. A lot of spiritual qualities associated with this tree. One of the other interesting features is its seeds are a host to a kind of a, well, they call it the jumping bean. So there's an insect inside it, and if you warm it up, it starts jumping around and it makes the seeds jump around. So lots of fun for kids to play with. As you can see, this one here has been made home to a termite mound, and the termites look like they're very comfortable there. Eventually, probably, they will take over the whole tree, but right now it's perfect symbiosis for both of them. That about wraps it up from me on this, the Tamboti tree. I hope you enjoyed it, and if we haven't met before, this is what I like to do, little stories about African plants, African trees. If you did enjoy it, there's plenty more on my YouTube channel, Facebook and Instagram, African Plant Hunter. And if you feel disposed towards supporting me in any way for the price of pretty much a cup of coffee a month, you could go to patreon.com/AfricanPlantHunter and just support me a little bit regularly, and that will enable me to make many more videos like this. So from me here in Gonarezhou National Park, I'm wishing you guys all the best wherever you are. Take it easy. I will catch you again. Bye.